First here at 11, a woman who lost her husband in a deadly crash calls a new political ad disgusting. A candidate uses her husband's death to promote his campaign. RTV6's Graham Hunter has her story.
You don't have a right to take other people's misery to use it for your own political gain. That's wrong. That's just downright wrong.
That's the message from a grieving widow in Avon.
Anyone that would use this situation in that way is disgusting.
Deborah Monroe's husband, Jeffrey, was killed while working as an Uber driver. His passenger, Indianapolis Colts linebacker Edwin Jackson, was also killed when they were hit on the side of I-70.
I cry myself to sleep at night. I truly miss my husband. He was the love of my life.
Manuel Orrego-Savala, an undocumented immigrant, is accused of driving drunk and killing Jeffrey and Jackson. Republican candidate for U.S. Senate Mike Braun mentioned the deaths in new radio and TV ads.
Drunk, he hit and killed Jeffrey Monroe and Colts linebacker Edwin Jackson.
To take this and publicize it for your own political advantage, that to me smells of desperation.
Monroe says her husband hated discussing politics and would not want to be used for political advantage, and says the ad misses the point about what happened the night Jeffrey was killed.
His immigration status didn't kill my husband. Had he not been drunk that morning, you wouldn't even know he was here. He'd have gone by them.
Build the wall.
He was against the wall.
And the chain migration.
We're all immigrants.
A statement from the Braun campaign. Mike Braun believes that Washington needs to stop illegal immigration, build the wall, and keep criminal illegals like the ones that killed Jeffrey Monroe and Edwin Jackson out of Indiana. Mike and his family are praying for the families of the victims. Monroe is clear about what should happen next.
I think that they need to pull this ad because I really am talking to someone to see what I can do about having it pulled.
Reporting in Avon, Graham Hunter, RTV6.
Now, we asked the Braun campaign for a response to Mrs. Monroe's request to remove the ad, but have not heard back. We'll let you know if we do.